Do you often find yourself worried about your child's development? Hi, I'm Priyanka Evangeline and I'm a speech language pathologist and the owner of Nurture Development Center, where I help children become better communicators as well as guide parents to help their children reach their communication goals. If you are already receiving therapy, then talk to your therapist. Most of the therapists in India have 5 minutes at the end of the session where they talk to the parent and discuss the goals and progress. So use that time wisely, note down all your questions and talk to them about it. If the 5 minutes is not enough, then you can book a session just for parent training or parent counseling and ask your therapist what you should do at home. The second thing is to find parent support groups. Now, there are many parents who have children with special needs who are now adults who are willing to share their knowledge and expertise with the new parents. So if you can find parents like this who have support groups, who have some program, contact them and talk to them. Each child, each person has their own learning curve. So initially, the child is very unaware of what they are learning. But as you keep teaching them, they slowly develop understanding and through repeated practice, they develop proficiency. So everybody has a learning curve and be patient whenever you teach your child some skills. Wait for them and give them chance and time to practice and to learn the new skills. We want to teach our child life skills that our child needs in order to communicate and participate in everyday life. These skills are very important. It cannot be rushed. Okay. So if your child is not learning a new word in a week or is not learning to communicate what they feel, then wait. Ask your therapist, find a strategy. Try again every day. And I'm sure as long as you try, your child will develop the skill. Now this third tip applies to you more than your child. You cannot pour from an empty cup. So I would suggest work 6 days or work 5 days in a week. So if you are part of my parent training program, you know that I give you plans for 5 days so that you have some plan and some direction to go through every day of the week. And on the weekends, take time for yourself. Do things that help you recharge your mind, refresh your mind, so that you can start once again on Monday. So on these 2 days, find different self-care activities that you can do and that you enjoy only for yourself. So these can be like, you know, at this moment, Zoom call with a group of your friends where you would drink tea or you drink green tea or coffee and you just talk about your life and everything for an hour or two. Or go out with your spouse, go for a walk, or get a manicure, or get a head massage. Buy yourself something new, or treat yourself with some good food. Do these self-care activities for yourself. And all of us have really bad days when we are so overwhelmed with emotions and feelings. So on that day, have a plan. So plan for these days, plan for difficult days. That is what I do. So I know that there are going to be some difficult days. So I have an action plan ready that I will do on those days. So if you have to cry, and if you know crying is your only outlet, cry. Nobody is telling you not to cry. And if you have a lot of feelings and you feel so much of things are going on inside your mind, then write it all down. Find an outlet. Tell somebody who does not judge you, or write everything down in a book, or just speak everything out. To imagine an audience and speak it out, and then watch some comedy. Like if you are in South India, then you might watch Aditya TV, or if you are in North India, you can watch Saab TV. Watch some stand up comedy. Watch Friends. Watch any kind of show or comedy that can lighten your mood. The fourth thing that I'm telling you is very important because there are studies that show that reduced sun exposure causes reduced vitamin D, which is mostly linked to depression and anxiety. So there is a condition called seasonal affective disorder. It's abbreviated to SAD, SAD. I feel the scientists felt very clever when they coined this term. Anyway, so this disorder happens in countries which have long periods of cold climates, because during cold climates we are all have less exposure to sunlight, and especially in this time of pandemic we don't go out much, and most of us are not exposed to sun. So vitamin D levels reduce in our body, and this is also linked to us feeling very sad and down or very upset. So make sure you get 15 to 20 minutes, 1 hour ideally, but try to get how much ever sun exposure you can in a day. It will really lighten up your mood. Find ways you can rest. It is completely devoid of any thoughts. If you like to meditate, definitely meditate. If you don't know how to meditate, find ways to do that. Also, make sure you get enough sleep, because sleep is the time our body, our mind especially, forms memories, where all the concepts and all the things that we've learned sets in. So sleep is so important for you and your child. You especially, just compare yourself to a phone. When the battery is low and you're opening too many apps in your phone, the RAM is spent and your phone heats up and doesn't work properly. Similarly, you too are taking care of too many things. You're taking care of family, your children, your work, your in-laws, so many things that you're caring for. Make sure that you also rest and recharge yourself so that you are able to help them more effectively. With these 5 tips, check out these activities and start working with your child after you have taken adequate rest. See you in the next video. Bye.